Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So today we are starting this last worksheet, translation worksheet, and sentence number 44. Lahore jaane wali train hadse ka shikar ho gayi. Okay, so this sentence is a simple past sentence, because as you can see the sentence in the end, it says shikar ho gayi thi, ho rahi hai. It is not using such kind of words, so you will say this is a simple past sentence. Okay, so Lahore jaane wali train. Now this is a complete phrase. You can say the train going to Lahore, okay, hadse ka shikar ho gayi. Now from here you use the, consider this whole phrase, the train going to Lahore, as your subject, and now you can write the verb and the object over here. The train going to Lahore faced an accident. Hadsa is an accident. Shikar ho gayi. Okay, you can write faced shikar ho gayi, faced an accident. Okay, so if you remember the structure of simple past sentences, then you won't face any difficulty in making sentences and translating them from Urdu. But make sure you, in the very beginning, as I told you earlier, when we were doing other worksheets, you have to find out whether the sentence which you are translating is an idiom or a phrase, whether it is a general sentence belonging to any of the tenses, or it is an imperative sentence giving you an order to do something, or it's a conditional sentence. You just need to find out the category and then accordingly make sure you translate it, and that all obviously comes with practice. Okay, this one you must have seen it in your past papers. Islamabad mein abhi tak zalzale ke jhatke mehsoos hote hain. Now this sentence, what do you say? Which tense is this? All right. So when you are translating this sentence, so write earthquake. Jhatke, you need to write tremors. Okay. Or still felt in Islamabad. All right. Now you need to make this as a passive one, because if you try to make it as an active sentence, then you will write earthquake. Islamabad feels earthquake tremors. So that is, not going to make proper sense. Okay, and then if you write earthquake tremors are still being felt in Islamabad, okay, that's a correct sentence. But in the Urdu sentence, it is not written mehsoos kiye jaate hain. All right, so that is why I've tried to translate it this way. Earthquake tremors are still felt in Islamabad. But you can reconsider, because sometimes in the translation you face this kind of difficulty. Here, though the sentence is such that it seems as if it's an active voice, but I am translating it as a passive voice, otherwise it won't be possible for you and the sentence won't make proper sense. All right, and so this seems the most appropriate one. Yes, you need to use your common sense also. Okay, the next one, kya tumhare dost aksar yahan aate hain. Now see, if you consider those rules in the previous sentences, was mehsoos hote hain, which shows that it's like a general present simple sentence. ही डज दिस, वो ये काम करता है. वी गो टू द पार्क, हम पार्क जाते हैं. बट फॉर द काइंड ऑफ सेंटेंस यू कैन नॉट से इस्लामाबाद फील्स अर्थक्वेक ट्रेमोर्स टिल नाउ और स्टिल फील्स अर्थक्वेक ट्रेमोर्स. I find it a bit, you know, strange, or it's an odd sentence. This sentence, you know, is not commonly used in our everyday conversation and writings, or you know, in the newspapers when you read these kind of news. So the proper sentence, which I feel, is earthquake tremors are still felt in Islamabad. Anyway. Here again, it's a simple present sentence and interrogative one. So you are going to translate it as do your friends usually aate hain, okay, not jaate hain, come. Do your friends usually come here? Okay. Do your friends usually come? Sorry, not come to here. Do your friends usually come here? Okay. Kya tumhare dost aksar yahan aate hain? Next one. Okay. Imtihan ek maah ke liye multavi kar diye gaye hain. Now, kar diye gaye hain means that something. This is present, and again an activity has been done in present. So that means this is a present perfect sentence. Okay. So exams have been multavi is postponed, have been postponed for a month. Okay, but the exams are going to be there. Okay, so this is your sentence. The exams have been postponed for a month. Allah hum sab humko sab ke saath yaksan sulook karne ka hukm deta hai. So Allah orders us to sulook karna, treat, okay, sabke saath, everyone. Yaksa is equal, so here you are going to write equally. I make it an adverb. Okay, how to treat everyone equally. Allah orders us to treat everyone equally. And the sentence is simple, present again. Apne badon ka adab kijiye. Now here it's very simple. You just need to see that it's an order, it's an imperative sentence. So you will simply write, respect your elders. And you've translated these kind of sentences earlier also. वालदेन हमसे बहुत प्यार करते हैं. ऑल राइट. पेरेंट्स लव अस वेरी मच. आपके उस्ताद क्लास में कब तशरीफ लाए. नाउ दिस इज गोइंग टू बी एन इंटरोगेटिव सेंटेंस बिलोंगिंग टू सिंपल पास्ट. तशरीफ लाए, लाए हैं, लाए थे, ला रहे हैं. इट्स सिंपली लाए. सो देन अच्छा, एंड देन कब इज व्हेन. सो व्हेन डिड योर टीचर कम टू द क्लास, एंटर द क्लास. ओके, व्हेन डिड योर टीचर कम टू the class or classroom. When did your teacher come to the classroom? When did your teacher enter the classroom? आपके उस्ताद क्लास में कब तशरीफ लाए? All right. Next sentence. आओ पार्क में टहलें. Now, let's walk in the park. In the park. That's the simple sentence. Now, these are a few sentences. You need to go through them, and we'll try to finish this worksheet tomorrow so that we can practice other questions also. And if you have any questions, especially with sentence number 45, I'll try to ask other teachers also if we are correct with this translation, or if there is some mistake, I'll just confirm. You can also just go through these sentences, and if you feel that any of the sentences you have a better translation for them, and we can discuss it obviously. So any question other than this, you can please ask me.